Yesterday, I published this circuit where I had the question, is this a new type of VHF oscillator? I had a few comments. Many thanks for that. Interested always. I had a comment, for instance, make this circuit in an SMD way. And there is another radio amateur, Stone Slice, who already made this circuit in an SMD way. I have given the link now in the first video, and I want to do that in this video. By the way, it's important that he introduced here, Stone Slice, I mean, so study the video that he made about this circuit. And especially look at his measurement results. That he introduced a tiny inductance here in his experiment, though the whole circuit is the same. And he made it with SMD components, service mounted device. So as small, as tiny as possible, to prevent all kinds of any kind of stray inductance. I have to put my camera down because I have forgotten to take in this video an important book, so I'm searching for that now. Yes, I have it. In this book, Radio Electronica, Electronic Yearbook 1968, I found very, very interesting table. And that table is here. And it's all about the resonance frequencies of capacitors. And I think that's very important because this table matches with my measuring results. So my conclusion is that this is an RC oscillator that in a very strange way, I've never seen that before, oscillates on VHF. Due to the value of the capacitor in combination with the resistor. So there is a lot of mathematics, and I'm very interested in these mathematics. I have to study that further, and everyone that can attribute to this question the mathematics of this circuit is very, very welcome. This is interesting. The resonance frequencies of capacitors, mica capacitors, 50 picofarad, 150 megahertz. And this is interesting, I used ceramic capacitors and it was 220 picofarad in this circuit, and that they say in this table that that frequency is 61 megahertz, and that matches a little bit with my the results of my measurements that I did in 2016 and now again in 2020. Of course, please don't comment on this test setup. Watch my earlier, the first video, where I have clearly explained that all the wiring here has no effect or a small effect on the resonance frequency. So this is interesting again. Say 1000 picofarad, 50 megahertz, and here a capacitor made with a dielectricum of say plastic or whatever. Plastic materials, they differ somewhat.
For instance, a capacitor of 100 picofarad ceramic has a resonance frequency of 135 megahertz, and a 100 picofarad capacitor made with, say, plastic materials. I don't know the right word at the moment for what is written here, but plastics has a resonance frequency of 117 megahertz. 100 picofarad, 117 megahertz, 100 picofarad, 135 megahertz. Though, of course, these are real differences, for sure. But when we talk about bands where capacitors work, this is not so relevant. So what I mean is that the capacitor plates and of course the dielectric material are in a certain way the dimension of these capacitor plates in combination with the material are responsible for, say, the resonance frequency. And they also discriminate not only the dielectricum between the plates, but also the type of capacitor, so a disc capacitor, a tube capacitor, and a ball type capacitor. And especially important, they in these measurements they have taken account of the wires, the length of the wires of the capacitor. When you have a capacitor here and make an oscillator, the length of the wire here can act, of course, as a kind of coil. It has inductance, and all these measurements here were done with legs to these capacitors of 25 millimeters long, so 2.5 centimeters. Anyway, this is the circuit for everyone interested that can directly be, say, connected, pressed into the electrodes of a 9-volt battery. And here is CX, responsible for the frequency for a big part. And here the 10K potentiometer, also responsible for the frequency. Please go to my first video about this. Anyway, so I want to demonstrate now what happens when I turn the wiper of the potentiometer here. This one, turn that. It makes a deviation of the frequency of, say, 10 megahertz. That's a lot. So, I'm going to do that now. Look at the scope and especially the counter. I now turn that wiper. And the amplitude diminishes, but the frequency goes up. Turn that wiper back. So between 68 megahertz and, say, 75 megahertz, I can vary the frequency of this oscillator by turning that potentiometer. And that also gives, in my opinion, more the idea that it is an RC oscillator. And I've never seen before an RC oscillator that works without coil in the VHF band. So I think it's quite unique. And perhaps there are practical applications. A coil is always, say, kind of element in an electronic circuit. Kind of problematic element in an electronic circuit. So perhaps when this is all integrated on, say, an IC board or whatever, on a chip, this could be a useful VHF oscillator without a coil. RC oscillator. And when all the, say, the parameters are stabilized, also a stable frequency must be the result.